Hello, greetings. This is Gilles Mancillon. I thought I'd come and communicate again today about the spiritual evolution, this energetic transformation that we are going through. In a sense, we need to return to the law of one, to the natural law, which is the moral law. But in this world, nothing is perfect. So we always have to find a place of neutrality and see what guidance we receive within each moment. And trying not to hurt anybody in our action, in our words, in our thoughts, in our action. Even our thoughts can be negative to other people. If we have negative thoughts towards someone, the energetic body receives it. So we want to forgive ourselves and cleanse our thoughts as much as possible. There is a very powerful tool. It says, when there is a fear, there is a doubt, say, I release you. I release you. So rather than cultivating and wonder why it comes or what does it mean, you just release it. And you can ask, there is two masters that have made a message about this. You can call on them, ask them to give them the permission to work inside of you, to liberate all your bodies from fear, from doubts. Is the Master Serapis Bay and Master Saint-Germain. They will come and they will assist you inside of you. If you ask them to assist you with that, I release you. So we all engage in this path of illumination. We are working towards illumination. We're all working towards this ascension, whether we're conscious or not. Even those who are not conscious, they want to return to that state of total bliss, total well-being, total fulfillment. So we are all working towards that. And the need, we have a certain need to get light, to lighten up, to become lighter, to eat lighter food. I'm trying to return to the vegan diet, but it's really hard there in France, and I'm really having a hard time. Even my test buds do not always accept many things, and so it's a slow but surely process. So we want to bring light and love into the food we eat. And we also need to breathe in prana, to be breathing consciously this oxygen, to be conscious, to take deep breaths, to be conscious of our breaths as much as possible, because our physical body needs physical food, but our light body needs prana, needs light to grow and to get strong. And so we also want to take the light of the sun, at least half an hour a day, direct sunlight. It's very important to mostly in the neck, or it's very important to utilize all the light rays of the sun. There's many little rays within the sun. We only see from red into violet, or to infrared to ultraviolet. But this is just a small spectrum of the light. There is so much that is given by the sun that we do not know. So we do want to take, even if there is clouds or it rains, doesn't matter. We need to be attuned to the light of the sun and take this direct sunlight every day to nourish ourselves, to breathe this light in as much as possible. We want to tune into the blue frequency of light, the divine wheel, the light of Sirius. Sirius is the dog star. It is part of the dog constellation. It is a system. It is a star that is twice bigger than the sun and 20 times more brilliant than the sun. And it is Sirius A, but then there is Sirius B, C, D. It's a cloud. There's many stars in Sirius, many civilization there. But we want to eventually, our whole solar system will integrate this light frequency. So Sirius is a portal to the galactic center. There are wonderful benevolent beings that have been working from Sirius, that have been working even before the fall of Atlantis, but are very they are the guardian of the sacred crystal of Atlantis. So we want to work with all the beings of Sirius. We want to connect to that frequency, connect to that light, connect to that portal, which will be even more activated as we pass through the Lion's Gate this year. Orion will be more activated, and the Giza pyramids will be awakened. Even in the Quran, Allah said, I am the Lord of Sirius. And so Sirius is a very important, it connects us to the silver cord, to the cord of the soul, it connects us to the soul, the fifth and sixth dimension, for that is an essential an essential connection, to be connected to our sixth and five and sixth dimension is our soul. And then the seventh dimension, there is our other soul, where we find the apex of our evolution. We already exist there. We just need to bring this consciousness down to our physical body. Most soul groups were created by 12. 12 members. For us, we were only five. We came in as five members of our group soul, but we're connected to a brotherhood. And then I consider my guides to be part of my spiritual family. And so, but we do want to connect to our guides. We want to ask our guides to manifest in this physical world. We want to ask for miracles. We want to work and know that those things happen. Those things are possible. They're potential. The more we believe, the faster it will come. And to be in gratitude as if it already had happened. It's not easy to move into a situation where we're not sure, we still maybe have doubts that it may just be part of our wishful thinking, so to speak. But it's about being there, being in this situation that we seek to become, and so ask your guide to assist you. It is important, for the soul is traveling. We have engaged in this long travel. It feels long because it's like hundreds of incarnations, but we're almost at the end of that cycle. If we do not, we're here to complete that cycle in this lifetime, but if we do not complete, we may have one or two more lifetimes to complete the past, to complete the circle of evolution for our own soul and for the planet, for we came here to ascend the planet, and if the planet is not ascended and we have to depart from this physical life, we'll choose to reincarnate. For many people will say, no, I don't want to reincarnate in this world, it's too hard, but once up there, we'll see the meaning of it, and then we may choose to reincarnate if necessary, unless we have completed the cycle, the circle. And for once we'll be ascended, or once we pass on and depart and we find ourselves in our higher self, we will look at all of those struggles, all of those problems, all of those difficulties, all the pain and everything that we've experienced down here as something very funny. We'll laugh at it. We'll say, well, it was so great. It's like, what a place. There's nowhere. It's such a short time when we see from an eternal standpoint. A lifetime is very short. So it's like, it's not to be taken so seriously. It's about accepting and releasing everything, because we are given this opportunity to ascend in this lifetime. So yeah, I'm going to pull a few cards. The paintings behind me, this is a painting about the I am that I am. It's like it's a series of paintings, and this is an astronomic painting. It's the number two of the series with the main planets of the solar system. And they all are connected to mythological story and divine energies. They all have frequency, they influence the collective, yet we, at some points when all those planets are here to give us back our power so we can elevate our consciousness above the conditioning, the filters of consciousness of the astrology, to return to the sphere of light and lucidity in the fifth and sixth dimension, to this natural state of being. And so I'm going to pull a few cards. The highest wisdom for us today is figure of authority. We have to become a figure of authority. We have let go of any external figure of authority. You are an expert on yourself. No one is better suited to know yourself. So do not take anybody's advice unless you feel it is completely appropriate. And if you receive an inner guidance, it is always higher, more important to follow that inner guidance than any external advice. What we need to understand is the wish. We made certain wish, and now we have to fulfill it. Sometimes it is painful to have to go through those things, but they are soul conditioned. They are part of our conditioning of our soul. They are of our soul matrix, and so we have to fulfill certain things. We came down here to fulfill certain things, and so our soul will keep on putting pressure on us until those things are fulfilled. And what we need to do is the trees. We need to grow, to be anchored in the earth, to be as trees. Trees have a much longer agreement with the earth. We all connected to the earth. We all have agreement with the earth. There are certain beings like insects that can have a very short agreement. They came here to live one day, but then the human beings, we came here to live 100 years maybe on average. We will be longer in time, but the trees. Some trees have agreement to live thousands of years, and the crystal have been here for hundreds of thousands of years. The diamonds for billions of years. So they have much longer certain life. There is life forms that we do not realize. Minerals are life forms, but they have a lot longer agreement with the evolution of the planet. For now, we have to become like trees. Trees are serene. Trees are growing. Trees are anchored. They're expanding towards the sky. But the trees always get the nourishment from the root. It is the root that nourishes the tree. So we have to reinforce the lower chakras, because we've been working through our upper chakras, and now we have to reinforce the base, because it's what supports the whole process for the Kundalini, so it can rise all the way to the Merkaba on top of our head, and reactivate the all the subtle chakras within our brain on the back of our head and within our brain and the sacred heart, the thymus. Those are several chakras. And the chakras are links between our physical and our astral body. They are etheric energy centers, like very small energy centers. They are like wheels, and they turn and spin. And the more we raise in the frequency of the chakras, the more spoke of the wheels they are, and then they grow and grow and grow as it elevates. And so we do want to ask the angels or to do this exercise every day to align our chakra. Every morning you wake up, you call on your guides, you could, the ones you know, or the ascended masters or the archangels. You call on them to reinforce your light. And then once your light is strong enough, this frequency of light that you feel comfortable with, you bring it down from your crown chakra into each and every one of your chakra. You align this light, and so it puts you in consciousness before you even wake up and you have any thoughts of the physical world. You do that exercise every morning. It only takes a few minutes, but it aligns your chakra. And then you can also ask an angel to come with a magic tuning fork to resonate the divine frequency of light within each and every one of your chakras. So you breathe and release. I release you. It's like we want to release everything, even the good. We want to release it, for the good will stay. We're not going to lose what's good for us by releasing it, by cutting the cords. We do this attachment. It's all only the attachment that can make us feel pain. But as we have no attachments, we are able to flow more freely. And the outcome is knighthood. It's about being strong. It's about being courageous. It's about defending values. It's about no blame and no shame. We've all been knighted in the past, and so we want to recall to those memories. My first memories that came to me this morning was two past lives. I was very much in my empowerment. It's like I had all the powers of heaven and earth on those lifetimes, although I was still mortal beings. But so those powers were like recalling those past lives. I knew for a long time that I had those incarnations, but they're coming stronger, and we can draw strength from all those identities, for it is no longer I, it is we, because we had those identities were different than what we are now, and it is so we need to reintegrate all those identities of the past life. Let it come to you. It's an Akash. And so we do want to connect to make it maintain this inner focus, and to train our brain to from beta state to alpha state, to be both connected to inner and outer, then go deeper into theta, and eventually go all the way down to the delta states and connect to the gamma states that connects us to the hyperspace consciousness of the fifth dimension. So we can utilize all of our brain. Our creator didn't create us to use 10-15% of our brain, or to use 3% of our DNA. We were created to use all of our brain, all of our DNA. So it's all awakening. This the sunlight, the power of the sun is very awakening all our DNA. And so we are moving towards the integration and the integration of those energies. And we'll pull the last cards. Two cards. The bottom cards is 10 of Michael. It is ended. You are finally free. Happiness awaits you. Leave the past behind you. So it's and the card on top is the moon. The opportunity to elaborate more, to refine your project. Let yourself be guided by your intuition. Confront your fear to be stronger. So it's always wise, and those cards are always given three phrases that's connected to wisdom. I'm not really that interested. I mean, it's not that I'm not interested about this all the ins and outs of the physical world. But as a spiritualist, I'm more interested in my own spiritual ascension, in my project, my cultural project, in my art, in connecting with all those who are interested in spirituality and art, than in confronting the world with all their many problems. It's like, but there are certain things I'm being asked to address, certain ideas about that. And so the point is that right now there is the political situation is being governed by two polar opposites, parties that are always in opposition. When we, in a sense, what we get to come in the future is a neutral state of politics. Politics has to be neutral as possible, and where we gather all the ideas and all the parties that can find all the best solution for the collective good, rather than being constant confrontation, trying to erase what someone has done. And so this opposition was created to divide people, and this for people to as a government, they take measure and they do not see where it goes. Sometimes it's successful, sometimes it is not. But they sometimes they don't have a medium and long term. They're always working in short terms. Sometimes they manipulate, as Immanuel Kant used to say, that the only transcendental power of politics is publicity. It's like whatever they say, if they can manipulate certain things, that people will believe what they have been told, when actually the truth is far different than what is being presented. For it's only by being once we're commanded by the heart that we find the solution, that because the heart knows the highest good of all, knows the cause and effect. So we want to eventually bring the highest wisdom, the beings that have the most administrative wisdom, those who are most attuned to the most high, to those who have this administrative wisdom that can manage the world and to rule by counsel in a fluid group dynamic. The idea is to serve the highest good of all, but what we want is to elevate the quality of life of the most. For certain people, we cannot serve everybody, because some people are abusing the system, and when you remove those abuse, you remove them their privilege. They will feel very they will not like it. But in order to, sometimes it's like to sacrifice the well-being of one person to serve millions, or one organization to serve millions, to serve billions. And so there is certain sacrifice that needs to be made, certain privilege that needs to be removed from some people and organization. For it is all about the quality of life, about simplifying the life, where everybody can feel included and find this creativity to serve the middle class. For I'm more on the right side, I'm more a Republican than Democrat in the Platonic sense, but there is certain left side ideas that I find completely necessary to eliminate poverty, the universal revenue, where everybody has enough to feed themselves, to house themselves, to educate themselves. So all that should be granted to all beings. They shouldn't leave anybody in poverty. There is enough resources for everybody to be taken care of. Yet I am for the free enterprise, for the ability for everybody. I'm not in the idea that everybody should be poor, so there is no jealous. It is not. It should be able. Everybody could be enrich themselves as much as they need. So the doors of the social elevator should function. For focusing on the middle class, for everybody should be able to find this the freedom of life, to simplify life. But the idea to take from the rich and give to the poor doesn't work. For those who know George Orwell, 1984, if you do not know, I recommend this book. It's an amazing book. And in the second chapter, the second part, the ninth chapter, there is the theories and practice of the collective oligarchism. It explains the ins and outs of the power, how the power maintain its power by creating these illusions. Once a population have accepted the lie, they can be told anything, they will follow the lie. So it's not to be used too much, because it's already so much there and we want to move beyond that, but it is important for the minority had been enslaved by this economical system. So we want to create a jubilee. It's all, Spirit says it's all in the work, and at some point there will be an event that's going to free humanity. Everybody will be shocked by that. But so we want to elevate the quality of life. That's really important, is to find well-being and simplify our life as much as possible, so we can develop our creativity. I hope those ideas resonate with you, for it's all adaptable in every country. Every land has karma, as every country, every civilization, every culture has to evolve in relationship to its past, present and future. But we do want to evolve towards a global peace, a global harmony, a human fraternity, where everybody, and there is a galactic technologies that are already here. They've been on the planet since the 50s. They were taken from extraterrestrials and then stolen by certain military group and super elites. For many of the super elites will be very useful in the transition. There is some that are psychopath and psychopath and psychopath. There is not much we can do for them. But there is certain people in the super elite world that will be very essential to the golden age, because they realize that in order to maintain their position, they have to assist in this transition. And they have so much power to affect the transition. So we want to be open to all the people that are, no matter what we think of them, to be open to work with everybody, to be open to be in acceptance. And some of those elite military groups or individual or families have already the replicators and all kinds of galactic technologies that will be useful. So that once we have that, we'll be able to be liberated totally from money. For we just need to ask the replicator for something, and it will create it. But the first sign of that coming was the 3D printer. But the first thing they did was to make weapons of war with that. So it's like if the replicator will have to be programmed so that no weapons can be created from them, because if a replicator is given and the first thing people do is to create to kill the enemies or to do harmful things to the planet or whatever, to do those insane things, the replicators have to come when people have achieved a certain level of maturity. But it's already on the planet, and very soon, as God willing, those technology will be liberated, will cure every ill. We'll put an end to starvation, we'll put an end to the destruction of animals and plants we'll no longer need. But there is all kinds of lobbies that are very powerful, the fossil fuel and nuclear and all those things that are very established, and they want to maintain their revenue, because there is already technology coming from, for instance, there is this foundation named Keshe in Belgium. It's an Iranian nuclear scientist that has those plasma reactor. I haven't really explored that, so I don't know how functional it is. I think his problem is that he doesn't want to sell them, he wants to give them, and like when you give something, people don't see the value. When you sell it, they paid something, so they see there must be some value, and then they start using it. But the zero point technology will with free energy that then, so it will solve most of our ecological problem. And there are many other technologies that are coming up and will solve most of the problems of the world. So let us stay optimistic in relationship to all that. Well, this message was interesting for you. I'll sing a song. It's like it's a song about, I don't know what to sing, and this song came to my mind. It's a song about the dream of moving to Los Angeles. I lived 7 years in Los Angeles. I had a wonderful time. I love this city. I have so many friends there. I went to university, I opened a gallery. I had a wonderful, wonderful time, although I wasn't very wasn't rich or anything. I had a very rich life, and it's like, so I'm looking forward to eventually maybe come back to LA, and if you're there, I hope to see you there. Hopefully I'll be traveling very soon. Goes like this. All the leaves are brown, the leaves are brown, and the sky is gray, and the sky is gray. I've been for a walk, been for a walk, on a winter's day, on a winter's day. I'll be safe and warm, be safe and warm, if I was in LA, if I was in LA. California dream, California dream, on such a winter's day. I stopped into a church, I passed along the way. Whoa, I got down on my knees, got down on my knees, and I pretend to pray, I pretend to pray. You know the preacher likes the cold, preacher likes the cold. He knows I'm gonna stay, knows I'm gonna stay. California dream, on such a winter's day. I thank you very much for sticking till the end. I thank you for liking, sharing, subscribing. I know that soon the doors are going to open for me. Spirit is saying to stay focused on that, because there is so much that will be here. As my life will change from is going to change radically very, very soon. I'm going to be able to do all those things that I've envisioned for years, to travel around the world, to bring this light, to bring my art, to bring this all kinds of ideas and project into the manifestation stage. And so to stay focused on that as it already had happened, just for me, it's like sometimes it's like, but I'm being able to deal with all the limitation of my present life with more ease. And as we deal with those things with more ease, more detachment, more neutrality, we know we are moving forward in this process of ascension. So I wish you to continue to stay focused on your highest dream, your highest vision, your highest fulfillment, and be in gratitude as it already had happened, and you'll see miracles will be manifesting. Thank you very much. Namaste.